Hi everyone, this is Karima and you're watching my channel Creativity World. So my today's project is about how to create this beautiful and elegant mixed media tag for Father's Day. Yes, it's completely handmade and I have added this tie as a shaker embellishment on this. And the cooling flowers are looking too refreshing, and in the shaker embellishment you will get a secret message, and I have added here Super Dad. So isn't it a great idea to gift your fathers on Father's Day that is upcoming? So without wasting any time, let's get started and move on to tutorial. So first here I'm taking this cardboard which measures 14 by 9.5 centimeters, and I have chopped the corners by triangles. Then I am just adhering one packing paper on top of this, like so. Then I am taking this doily, and this is half doily, and I am just attaching this on the corner. Then I am taking hole punch machine, just finding first center and then hole punch. Now it's time to create the shaker embellishment. For this I have already cut out this tie. First I have created the tie, then I have created double inner side and then cut out with paper cutter. Then I am taking OHB and acetate sheet and taking one similar way tie and just added one yellow color paper on top of that. Now I am adding glue and just attaching this acetate sheet with this tie cut out, like so. Then I am just going to create some dimensions. For that I am taking these flaps, pieces of rectangle, pieces of cardboard. These helps to create the dimensions. So I am adding glue and just layering, and then I am just attaching with this cutout, tie cutout. So it's done. I have added this. Now it's time to add the secret message. So here I am adding Super Dad. You can also add any kind of other your own choice sentiment here. This is handwritten sentiment. So I've added this. Now I'm taking this shaker embellishment pack. In this pack you will get some sequences, microbead pearls, and many more multicolored beads, microbead pearls. Now I'm adding some sequences, microbead pearls, half sequences, some pipes, and then I'm just going to add some sequences, purple color sequences here. Then I'm just adding this glue on side portions, then just spreading this with my fingers, then just add the yellow color tie cut out on top of that. Okay, so now I'm just taking this 7 mm strip and just adding to the side corners of the tie, like this. So it's done. Now on the top of that I'm just adding the same tie cut out, and I have added this sentiment, you rock. Okay, so it's ready. Now for the upper bow, here I'm taking this ribbon, just cutting down, and then I have created a circle eye shape and secure this with tape. Then just you have to fold this from center, staple it from center, folding side corners, then again staple, you have to staple it like so. So it's ready. You have to attach it with glue on the top of the tie, so it will like a do like a collar of the tie. But here I have not created the shirt. If you want, you can also create that. It's done. Now it's done. I have added one strip. It's mixed media, you can do anything. Now it's time to do some texture work. For this I'm taking mixed media paste. The proportion is that you have to take 1 teaspoon of plaster of Paris, or you can also take wall putty or talcum powder, and in this you have to add 1/2 teaspoon of fevicol and 1/4 teaspoon of water. I'm taking my stencil and just adding this. This stencil you have also seen in my previous videos. Just spreading it. So proportion is that if you take 2 teaspoons, then you have to add 1 teaspoon of fevicol and 1 strip of water also. Okay. It's depend upon the big size of the tag and how much quantity of mixed media paste you want to create. Okay, I just created Ollie, which I have to want to use. Spreading it using my palette. Now just remove the stencil slowly, wholly, and carefully and gently. Then just scrapping the excess paste which is overcoming from the stencil, because this is a homemade stencil, but the result is good, not bad, we can say. Okay, just scrap out. And I have washed the stencil. Now it's dried nicely. I am taking a poster color. Only the coloring portion you have to do only when it's dry. Otherwise, if you do very hastily, your texture will get distorted. Now I am adding some water and just adding some water, and it will automatically create their shape. Just you have to shake it, and your design will automatically create. You don't have any. Just shake it, and the pattern paper automatically will. Now taking with orange one, shake it. So it's dried. Now it's time to do. So it's time to make the flowers, quilling flowers. For this, I'm taking one fourth strip of purple and one strip of orange. And first, I'm creating tight coil, then loose the coil. Then just add glue and pinch all the corners, creating the inner tight coil in the center, and just fold it. And add glue and just cover this whole petal using 1/4 strip of purple color. And Malaysian flower petal is ready. You can also see that in my previous video, Malaysian flower petal. I will give the link in description box. Now for the next shape, we are taking this 1/4 strip of red. Just created a tight coil, loose the coil, and create a teardrop shape. Now for the leaf, again taking 1/4 strip of green, and then just pinch this from both the corners. Now I'm proceeding to arranging my flowers. So I'm just adding in oil and creating a flower like shape. Adding 1/2 cut pearl in the center. Then for the red flowers, just doing the same process. And here I'm not adding pearl, here I'm adding this purple color sequence. Then you have to just little bend all these flowers to give these a 3D look on your palm. Just take it and just press it on your palm. Now it's time to make the scrolls. For this, I'm taking 1/4 strip green and 1/4 strip of purple, arranging all these like so. Here I have done, and just finding center and then quilling. You can also use tweezer, and you can also use the nip of the scissor. Add a little glue, hold it and just open it slowly. Then side portion and just following it. Now I have added, I want to create the eyelet, but if you don't have eyelet, you can simply take any bead and just insert this bead to the punched portion. Now it's time to arrange all these things. So corner portion, I am going to adhere my flowers, and side portions I am going to adhere my red flowers. So now here I am just adding my tie embellishment. You can also add guitars, anything of your choice. It's mixed media. Okay, now just adding scrolls. the bead portion is also substitute for the eyelet if you don't have eyelet. Then I am just adhering in that way that they look 3D, little 3D look. Not just bend these all, but give this them by pressing to give little 3D look. Okay, now I'm taking this sentiment, hip hip hooray, it's your special day. And I have just creating a flaps of cardboard and just added to give this also a 3D look and a dimensional, but little dimension. So I'm just pressing it and it's done. Now I'm creating here handwritten sentiment dad. So here I'm adding on the top of the flowers. Okay, now for the ribbons, inserting these ribbons through my tag and just tie a knot and just cutting down the corners of the ribbon. Like so. On the top, I have added this bead again. Now just curling with using my scissor this ribbon. So it's ready. You'll see how the shaker embellishment look like. Wow. So isn't it a great idea to gift your fathers on Father's Day? If you don't have sentiments, you can first take out the images from Google and then print out that according to your choice, that happy birthday sentiment, many other sentiments of your choice. In the same way, I have created this one also. I have added some here, layers, jute, cheesecloth, eyelet, etc. So my project is done. Hope you enjoyed this. Please subscribe my channel for more such innovative ideas. And don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest updates. Thanks for watching. I will back again with another crafty ideas. Until then, bye.